This screencast will apply the concepts learned in Chapter 4, Heat Exchangers, to the chlorobenzene production plant started in Chapter 1, Introduction to Aspen Plus. To begin, open your chlorobenzene production plant simulation you saved after Chapter 3. Go to the simulation environment. Create two heater models before the benzene and chlorine feeds and label them appropriately. We will use these to model heat exchangers. With the heater model, we do not need to specify anything about the heating or cooling medium. This would allow us to choose the most economical exchanger medium if we refine our design in the future. We are not sure what utilities will be available to the plant. Connect the original chlorine and benzene feeds to the heater outlets and add a new feed stream to the heater inlets. Relabel the streams appropriately. When you're finished, your flow sheet should look like this. Click on the green next arrow to enter information about the benzene feed heater. Specify the outlet temperature of 55 degrees Celsius and an operating pressure of 2.4 bar. Input the same values for the chlorine feed heater. Click on the green next arrow to specify information about the new benzene feed stream. Specify that it now comes in at room temperature and a pressure of 2.4 bar. Chapter 5, Pressure Changers, will explain how to bring your stream from atmospheric pressure to the design pressure. Enter the same flow rate and composition as specified in the problem statement. Aspen will ignore the operating parameters previously inputted for the benzene feed 2 stream. It will override that data with its calculated variables. Pressing on the green next arrow will bring you to the chlorine feed stream. Again, specify that it enters at room temperature and a pressure of 2.4 bar. Enter the same flow rate and composition as specified in the problem statement. Save your file where it can be accessed later. Watch the following tutorial screencasts in Chapter 5, Pressure Changers, to continue the series.